G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, just going to go through setting up for the bearers. And obviously, the position of our piers is dependent on the allowable span of our bearers. So you can see there I've got all the piers in place, but I just put the bearers in and that refresh. So the distance from this bearer, this pier, to this pier here is going to be dependent on what the allowable span for our bearer is, and also the distance from this pier here to this pier here is going to be dependent on what the allowable span for our joist is. So generally I try and make them roughly the same, but we have to go and have a look at a set of span tables to find that information. Now, span tables are generally based on, here in Australia, AS 1684.2 for my area, but they're not freely available. However, there are a number of organisations and companies that put out software, or they put out their own span tables that comply with 1684, and you can use those. So the ones I'm going to use today are the TABMAR ones, which are these ones, and I'll put a link up for this in the bottom of the description of the video. But there's also other software like Hein put out their Hein Design 7.5. So that all complies with Australian standards, and I'll put a link into a video about that as well. There's another software called Timber Solutions, which you can get for free, but you generally have to register to get them. Okay, so this set of tables has a couple of different sections. So this is for supporting roof loads. So this is for internal floor joists not supporting roof loads. So obviously that's not us, so you can not worry about that one. Floor bearers. So this is the one we need for domestic balconies or decks. Okay, so you can see they're sort of broken up. There's a lot of different columns and a lot of different rows. So you can see here, if you look over here, this is for softwood F5, softwood F7, and MGP10. So I'm going to run with MGP10 because that's what you can commonly buy out of the hardware stores at the moment. You also have single span or continuous span. So I'll go back to here. So if you're going to run your bearers full length, all right, and they're going to go over one joist or one pier or more, they are continuous span. If they only span from this pier to this pier, they are single span. Okay, so the ones I'm going to use are continuous span. So I can use the continuous span side. So that puts me down into this group of figures. And I want to, the other thing here is, what they call the floor load width. And again, I've got a video on that, but basically that's the distance or the amount of floor that that particular bearer is going to carry. So it's basically, it's equal to the span as well, okay, if you like. So I'm going to try and work with a span of about 1.5. I like that as a sort of a good span. So I can't use the 1.2 column. I'm going to have to use the 2.4 column. So I'm going to come down this column. So as I said, I want to get to about 1.5 meter span for this job. And it's up to you guys how you want to do it. Whatever you think is more economical, as far as the amount of timber you're using for its cost and how far it actually spans, okay? So if I look here, to achieve a 1.5 meter span or 1500 millimeter span, I can use two 120 by 35s, nail laminated together, okay? And that'll also give me a 400 mil cantilever, which I'll explain in a minute. Okay, so I think I'll run with that. I'm gonna use a 120 by 35. So I can come back to my deck. So here I'm going to use 120 by 35, two of them nailed together, and that will allow me to span or space my piers this way 1.5 meters apart. I'll have to go and have a look at the joists to see how far apart I can do them there, and I'll do that in the next video.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.